Hi there, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm excited to share with you my recent training and race experience. Over the past 6 weeks, I've been working hard to prepare for a 10 km race, and I'm pleased to say that my hard work has paid off. Let me walk you through my training schedule leading up to the race. Week 1, I started off strong with a 2 km warm-up followed by 8 sets of 400 m intervals at a pace of 3:30 per kilometer with 90 seconds of rest in between. I then finished off with a 2 km cool down. The next day I ran a steady state 30-minute run at a 4:30 per kilometer pace with another 2 km cool down. On Thursday I tackled the tempo run with 20 minutes at a 4 per kilometer pace, followed by a 10 minutes at 4:30 per kilometer pace, and then finished off with a 2 km cool down. I also ran an Adidas tempo run of 7 km at a 4:20 per kilometer pace, and finally on Friday I did 6 sets of 60 seconds hill repeats at maximum effort with a 2 km cool down. Week 2, I continued to push myself with 10 sets of 400 m interval at a pace of 3:40 per kilometer, followed by a 2 km cool down on Monday. Tuesday was a steady state 35-minute run at a 4:30 per kilometer pace with 1 km cool down. On Thursday I ran an Adidas tempo run of 7 km at a 4:15 per kilometer pace with a mix of faster and slower splits, and then did 8 sets of 60 seconds hill repeats at maximum effort with a 2 km cool down on Friday. I finished off the week with an easy 12 km run on Sunday. Week 3. This week I did 5 sets of 1 km intervals at a pace of 3:50 minutes per kilometer with 90 seconds of rest in between, followed by 1 km cool down on Monday. Tuesday was another steady state 35-minute run at a 4:30 minutes per kilometer pace with a 2 km cool down. On Thursday I did a tempo run where I ran 7 km at a pace of 4:10 minutes per kilometer, followed by a 15-minute warm-up and an 8 sets hill repeat session on Friday. I wrapped up the week with a rest day on Sunday. Week 4. This week started with a rest day on Monday, followed by 5 sets of 1 km intervals at a pace of 3:55 minutes per kilometer with 90 seconds of rest in between, and a 2 km cool down on Tuesday. On Thursday I ran an easy Adidas run and did 8 sets of 60 seconds hill repeats at maximum effort with a 2 km cool down on Friday. I took it easy on Saturday with a trail run and another trail run on Sunday to wrap up the week. Week 5, the 5th week, started off with 5 sets of 1 km intervals at a pace of 3:55 minutes per kilometer with 90 seconds of rest in between and a 2 km cool down on Monday. Tuesday was a steady state run of 45 minutes at a 4:30 per kilometer pace. On Thursday I ran a 1 km warm-up followed by 5 km tempo run at 4:03 minutes per kilometer pace with a 2 km cool down. I did a 10k tempo run at a 4:05 per kilometer pace on Saturday and finished the week with an easy 15 km run on Sunday. Finally, in week 6 I started the final week of my training with a 2 km warm-up followed by 10 sets of 400 m intervals at a pace of 3:30 per kilometer with 90 seconds of rest in between and a 2 km cool down on Monday. Tuesday was a rest day to allow my body to recover. On Wednesday I challenged myself with a workout consisting of 5 sets of 1 km at 3:40 per kilometer pace followed by 1 km at 4:30 per kilometer pace. Thursday was a recovery day where I opted to bike instead of running. I continued my bike training on Friday, which was another rest day for running. I wrapped up my training with an easy run and some strides on Saturday to prepare for the race on Sunday. As you can see, I followed a pretty intense training plan that included a lot of different types of runs to help me build up my endurance, speed and strength.
Do it now!
I really pushed myself during each of these workouts and I could definitely feel myself getting stronger and faster as the weeks went on. And then came the big day, race day. I was feeling pretty nervous leading up to the race, but also really excited to see all of my hard work pay off. The course was challenging with some twists and turns, but I felt confident in my ability to tackle it. As soon as the starting gun went off, I set out at a strong pace, completing the first kilometer in 3 minutes and 53 seconds per kilometer. I kept up the pace for the next few kilometers, completing the second kilometer in 3:57 per kilometer, the third in 3:54 per kilometer, and the fourth in 3:58 per kilometer. By the time I hit the fifth kilometer, I was feeling the burn, but I managed to push through, completing it in 3:54 per kilometer. The next few kilometers were tough, but I stayed focused on my goal and kept pushing myself. I completed the 6th kilometer in 3:58 per kilometer, the 7th in 3:58 per kilometer, and the 8th in 3:59 per kilometer. As I approached the final kilometers of the race, I could feel my energy starting to flag, but I pushed through, completing the 9th kilometer in 3:56 per kilometer, and the 10th kilometer in 3:56 per kilometer. But the route was longer than 10 kilometers and I still had 220 meters to go. I dug deep and found the energy to pick up the pace, finishing the last stretch at a 3:32 per kilometer pace. My official time for the 10:22 kilometer race was 40:09 with an average pace of 3:56 per kilometer. I was really proud of myself for finishing strong and pushing myself to my limits. It was a great feeling to know that all of my hard work and training had paid off. The experience taught me that with dedication, perseverance and hard work, anything is possible. Overall, I feel like all of the hard work and dedication that I put into my training really paid off in the end. I'm looking forward getting back out there to see what else I can accomplish. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.